Hi everyone, delonewolf here. Welcome back to some EVE Online exploration. In today's video, I think we are going to take a look at what is the best exploration ship for HiSec, at least the combat exploration ship for HiSec. It is without a doubt the Gila. Now I'm going here with a passive Gila. I would love to put an oversized shield wrapper in there, but it's got cap problems, it's got fitting problems for me, so I went with extra HP with a large shield extender and then the right resistances, of course. But I spurred a little bit on the drones here, because we got augmented infiltrators, which should be perfect because they also hit EM thermal. So overall, I am really curious to see how this one is going to perform in this 4 out of 10. Should be a race for the record. What I also like about the Gila is of course the fact that its damage types are actually, in my opinion, a little bit better for these types of sites. What do I mean by that? Orbit at 500. What I mean by that is that I like to spread the missile damage to the small ones, and then what is the bulk of my DPS, it's actually these drones, and then use that on 33 kilometers is just a little bit too far, so we have to wait just a touch. But have those missiles, and look at what one missile does to these little guys, right? Just completely obliterates those guys. That is really nice, of course. And then we can put the large drone on there, and then I've got a much better follow-up as well of knowing which target has been blown to pieces. And so we are going to try and clear all of this out very quickly and effectively. Let's also grab another medium. Let's blow this guy up. Go for that one. That one. My drones go on this one. On the Phantasm. And I feel like this fits a little bit better with the goal of hitting the right target with the right weapon type. You've got rapid light missile launchers that are making very short work of all of these frigates, and then you have your drones that take care of the bigger targets like that. And this way it's the right DPS, it's the best application possible on all of these targets. That's almost all the frigates down. We still have a couple of cruisers left and a little bit of damage on one of my, so let's go like this, let's start firing missiles at one of the cruisers. Take a look at how that DPS performs here. But yeah, we got a little bit of shield damage, but nothing too major. And in the meantime, let's take a look at the drones just eating that cruiser up like it is absolutely nothing. Now, what I am a little bit worried about is, of course, the fact that I am. Let's also do a reload of this one. Is that I'm passive, and so I've got a limited pool of HP in order to survive the rush in the second room. But actually, what I'm curious here is 3 minutes. And a little bit for the first room. That definitely feels nice and fast. Let's get the afterburner once the infiltrators are on board. Let's go for the second room. Is how long is it going to take me to clear out the entire second room? Maybe we'll start out by just rushing for the loot, trying to survive that, then we'll pull away, and then we'll see what we can do when it comes to clearing out the rest of the rats there. But this felt, in my opinion, the very best option when it comes to running these sites. You just have such good damage application, you take care of everything. You're also a little bit more busy. Oops, let's look for that true Sansha. There it is, 40 kilometers. Approach, afterburner around, infiltrators, go do your job. And in the meantime, what I'll do is I'll also target some of this small stuff. But yep, let's go, true Sansha Foreman. It needs to be blown to bits. Let's see how two missiles do against one of these small guys. Just a quick test. So that's half and then half again. Alright, in the meantime, my drones are just eating that true Sansha rat up like it's absolutely nothing. He does rebel up a lot, we know that. But yeah, this won't be too much of a problem normally. Blap, he is down. Need to spot the loot. There it is. Let's grab that. And then let's see if we can indeed just do a quick one shots. Yeah, use full. That's also an option if you want to go like that. Just put all your missiles on a single frigate. But I do feel that from time to time you'll be like wasting a little bit of potential DPS by doing that. Here's the loot. 183 million. That is definitely not bad. Then we'll pull away a little bit. And then let's see what else we still have in range. Like this one, I think on these tiny little rats that we will be wasting at least a little bit of our DPS by using full missiles. But this does make it easier, basically, because you know exactly what you're doing and what you're going to one-shot like this. So that one is gone, and let's see if the slave hunter can be next. In the meantime, I'm just mostly letting my drones go after the targets that they choose. And yep. Those guys go down in a single shot as well. Still gonna let this go. Oh, 36. That's actually a little bit too far. That is maybe the one disadvantage. It's the range. Let's ask this guy to come back. It is, of course, much stronger than in any other ship. Also a big advantage that we're noticing here. That is that these drones can tank quite a little bit. If you want other options, let's grab a hammerhead. Let's grab a nearby target. And yeah, and also one disadvantage, like right here. I mean, we got to that loot pretty quickly. We're 6 minutes in and we are going after some more of these cruisers. But the reload time is really horrendously long. That is indeed a little bit of a disadvantage. But yeah, just look at those drones tanking all that damage. Far more comfortable doing this than having my drones attacked in any of the other ships, of course. And as a result, we are just one-shotting all these frigates off the field. Like that. Plenty of options in damage types as well, right? You can get the right missiles, you can get the right drones. All of that, you can just tune this ship perfectly, including the resistances, considering the feat that I'm using here is highly focused on just resisting everything and having enough HP. So you can definitely tune this to the sites that you are doing. Such a great combat exploration ship, such a great PvE ship in general. Just the right damage types, the right shields. Properties, all of it is just absolutely perfect. So next up, we'll hit that juggernaut with a couple of missiles and then he'll just be blown up like that. So apparently what could work here is just do one missile like that to get rid of their shields, or most of their shields. Let's do that one as well, that one as well. I'm just trying to find like an efficient way of cruising through this. And like that, that's quite all right. You're next. Another missile on that. And then my drones that have just really the raw damage should have a better time like that. Blap, just completely gone because it didn't have any shields left. And let's see if now they're spreading their damage out. So we're going to launch the final missile on that cruiser as well. But yeah, just one drone. Look at how much damage it does. Blap, no problem. Half his armor, single shot from a single augmented drone, and blap, he's gone. Room done in like 8.5 minutes or something like that. So this is basically, if you're, I think as an alpha you can fly this as well, but if you're alpha or omega and you're looking to do that high-sec combat exploration ship, and also regardless of space, this is probably the ship that you want to shoot for. The Gila, such an amazing ship. And yeah, the results, sometimes they can be there as well, of course, with a true Sansha diagnostic system, 45 million, and a true Sansha warp disruptor, 135 million. Man, if I would use a Muta plasmid on that and get something good, that might be worth a gamble. Anyways, that's it for this quick EVE Online video, guys. Good luck out there, and I'll see you all next time.